This is the GPD Pocket, an atom-powered computer that claims to be the smallest laptop in the world. I reviewed and tested this laptop not that long ago, and that video ended with a small test on Overwatch that gave better results than I initially expected. Since then, a lot of people have asked, but Alex, how does it perform in actual matches? So I decided to test while trying a performance trick that people have been throwing around both the LowSpecGamer subreddit and the Discord to get some extra performance on some really low-end computers. So, time to take a quick, extra look at Overwatch on a tiny laptop. Also, are you looking for ways of improving your online connection to reduce network lag? This video is sponsored by Outfox, an optimized network for gaming to reduce latency. The service is finally out of beta and fully functional. If you're playing on one of the compatible games, all you need to do is to leave the program open in the background and let the service do its thing. And they have been supporting this channel over several videos now, so be sure to check them out if you're interested using the link in the description. And now, back to the video. The first thing that I have to mention is that on my GPD Pocket video, I pointed out that the device was not making full use of its available resources. I was right to think this was caused by a temperature limit. Shortly after I did that video, an updated BIOS was released and it allowed me to finally check the temperature limits. The CPU's maximum temperature was set to somewhere between 57 to 60 degrees. Yikes! So after researching the thermal limits of the chip, I decided to change it to something around 80 degrees. Given the small form factor of this device, it is unlikely that it will be able to cool itself down and make full use of the CPU and GPU, but this is going to give us at least a bit more performance. If you own one of these devices or plan to do so, there's a Reddit thread with the updated BIOS in the link in the description. So now that we have dealt with thermal limits, I wanted to talk about resolution. The configuration file that I have used so far is in windowed mode, since Overwatch normally does not allow custom resolutions if they're not windowed. While this is fine on a bigger monitor, this is particularly problematic on the GPD Pocket's small screen. Unless you have an external monitor, you will find this very hard to use. This is why I have seen plenty of laptop users in the community making use of the hotkey resolution changer. This is a program that will allow you to change the resolution of the entire PC to a lower one with a simple button press. Fullscreen Overwatch only seems to support up to a lowest fullscreen resolution of 1024 by 768. However, you can add a custom low resolution on your GPU's control panel and it will show up in the resolution list for the resolution changer. In the case of the GPD Pockets, the custom resolution must be rotated due to the way the screen is connected, and you should set a rotation in the resolution switcher for it to work properly as well. But in most other laptops, this should not be needed, and you can just simply add your resolution normally. So, all you have to do is to set up a really low resolution on one button combination and your normal resolution on another. Start the game and then use the low resolution button combination to switch to something lower. When you're done playing, you can use the other button combination to return to your original resolution. This, combined with the configuration file that I have been using so far, just changed to full screen, can give you some delightfully low resolution results. The new config file is linked in the description.
I feel like I'm losing 30% of my view area to performance metrics, but I thought in this case it might be important for you to notice exactly how the resources of this tiny computer are being used. I'm filming this right a couple of days after they push the patch to change Mercy. Oh dear god. Yeah, this might be maybe a bit too low for resolution. I guess we're gonna find out. I must admit, it's really interesting and praiseworthy of the design of this game that even playing this on godly low resolution, I'm kinda able to tell what is going on or who am I supposed to help. Oh, right, yeah, I can revive people now, I keep forgetting about that. I'm taking care of you. Oh god, no. Yeah, I gotta remember how to play with Mercy again.
I will watch over you!
No, I can't get it! Okay, that was disappointing. That was extraordinarily disappointing. Well, that was a complete disaster. So as some people know, actually my main character has been drifting more towards D.Va, and she suffered some changes as well, so curious to see how she's going to do now. Oh, whoa, 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 that was quick. Oh, we actually took that. Well, that's good. This new missile attack is very hard to handle. It's hard to figure out when exactly to use it. Come on, come on, we almost have it, we almost have it. Come on, come on, come on, give it to me, give it to me. Let's see how it goes. I got someone, I think I got... How did it... What? Okay, I feel really stupid now.
So, with a small tweak, you can use this to play this game full screen on a really small device. Before leaving, I want to thank everyone that participated on the Photoshop contest on the LowSpecGamer Discord. The challenge this time was to play around with movie and TV posters, and some of the results were pretty hilarious. I'm truly having a blast with the things you're coming up with. Thank you to everyone in Patreon who supports this content, as well as the sponsor. See you all on the next video.